Okay, hi and welcome to another Ben Golding Guitar Masterclass. Today we're going to have a look at a bit of absolute classic pop, one of my favourite tunes, Britney Spears and the wonderful Hit Me Baby One More Time on the acoustic guitar. Okay, this should be really straightforward, and the way we're going to do it is definitely a way that I'm sure even beginners can have a go at, and if you're a singer as well, it's a brilliant one to do as part of your set. If you're a bit more advanced, you might want to try a few more finger picking, something a little bit more elaborate, you know, on this one. But just straightforward chords, easy strumming patterns should be no problem at all for anyone out there. Okay, the first thing I want you to do, this is for the same key as the original Britney Spears one. So obviously if you're a vocalist with a different type of voice, you can try putting the capo in different positions or playing it without a capo. But for the Britney Spears one that we're going to be playing with, it's capo on the 3rd fret. Okay, so get your capo, put it straight on the 3rd fret. Now what I'm going to do is give you the chords first of all. They're very straightforward, so you may well know them, but I'm just going to quickly go through them, so try and get used to these if you don't already know them. But the chords in this song, we've just got A minor, E major, C major, and then D minor, and then it goes back to E major again. And there's also, there's a kind of a bridge section at the end which uses F, and it's also got a G in it as well. So just have a quick run through those, see if you know them already, but what we're going to do is try and play them. I'll go through them very, very quickly for you in case you don't know them. Okay, so first of all, A minor, for that one, you want to put your first finger on the 2nd string in the 1st fret. And obviously I'm giving you all the fret numbers relative to the capo. Yeah, so the capo starts on 0 and then it's going to go 1st, 2nd, 3rd, 4th frets, that way up. Okay, so A minor, first finger on the 2nd string in the 1st fret, next finger on the 4th string in the 2nd fret, next finger on the 3rd string in the 2nd fret. Okay, that is your A minor. Okay, a nice easy change. E major is just literally taking the A minor and moving every finger up one position to the next string up. And then that gives you an E major. So that's going to be first finger on the 3rd string in the 1st fret. Next finger goes on the 5th string in the 2nd fret. And the next finger goes just underneath that on the 4th string in the 2nd fret. Okay? And for that one, it won't be a huge mistake if you don't do this perfectly. But with A minor, that was the first chord, you're trying to hit 5 of the strings. You're missing the one at the top. And for E major, you're going to hit all the strings. Okay? Then C major is the next one. Bit of a stretch on this one. You've got your first finger on the 1st fret on the 2nd string. Next finger goes in the 2nd fret on the 4th string, and then the next finger goes in the 3rd fret on the 5th string. And then with this one, C major, we're trying to hit 5 of the strings, okay? So that is your A minor, E major, C major. D minor is the next one we're going to look at. For this one, you've got your 1st fret on the 1st string, so that's right down at the bottom there. Okay, the next one is the 2nd fret on the 3rd string, and the next one is the 3rd fret on the 2nd string. And with this one, we're trying to hit 4 of the strings. You're trying to miss the 2 at the top. And it's just the bottom 4 strings. Okay, after that, let's have a quick look at an F major. For F major, basically it's a little bit tricky, and a lot of beginners do have a problem with this, so you might need to practice it over and over to get it just right. Because for the F major, you're trying to hold down the 2 bottom strings, that's strings 1 and 2, with the 1st finger. Okay, it's a bit of a push, that might take a little bit of time. That's the 1st and the 2nd strings in the 1st fret with one finger. Okay, the next finger goes on the 3rd string in the 2nd fret, and the next finger goes in the 3rd fret on the 4th string. And with this one, we're trying to hit 4 of the strings. Okay, if you have a massive problem with F major, what you can do, it's a little bit of a corner to cut and everything, it won't sound exactly the same, but what you can try doing is instead of doing both of the strings in the 1st fret, the bottom 2 strings, you can just try and do the 2nd string, okay? And it makes it a lot easier. And that chord will actually be an F major 7, but it sounds very similar and it's much, much easier. So if you do have a real problem holding down that bar over 1 and 2, then just try doing it just on the 2nd string in the 1st fret and the other 2 fingers the same. Okay? Okay, so there's your F. Okay, next up, let's have a look at the G major. Okay, for this one, all we need is the 5th string on the 2nd fret, bit of a stretch on this one. Then the next finger goes on the 6th string in the 3rd fret. And then the last finger is on the 3rd fret again, but right at the bottom on the 1st string. Bit of a stretch, but it shouldn't be too difficult if you take a bit of time and practice it. Okay? So now that's quite a few chords, so if you don't know them too well, maybe stop the video and have a quick try on those chords. We want the A minor, the E major, the C major, the D minor, okay, that's the first batch, and then also the F major, and then the G major. Okay, if you're comfortable with those, that's great, but if not, just try practicing and making sure you can change them, okay? Okay, so the main song, the great thing with this is most of the song is just the same chord sequence all the way through, yeah? So what we want is A minor, 4 strums, E major, 4 strums, and then C major, 4 strums, and then a little bit of a quicker change, D minor for 2, and then E major for 2. Okay, and that really is most of the song, so you want to take a long time just going through those chords. A minor, E major, 4 strums, C major, 4 strums, and then D minor for 2, and then E major for 2. And then just to give you, excuse the singing, but I'll give you the melody in the background so you can kind of hear how the chords relate to the song. This is the... and so on. Let's just try that a little bit more, a little bit slower, and hopefully you'll get the picture with that one. So A minor again. D minor for 2 and E for 2. And again, A minor for 4, 3, 4, E major for 4, and C for 4, D minor and E major, and C. All the way through. Tell me how you want it to be. Tell me da 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 da. And so on.
The loneliness is killing me, and I must confess.
And so on.
Still believe.
See how that melody goes over that chord sequence all the way through. So basically, slow it right down, do that as much as you can. The chords, they shouldn't give you too much problem, even if you're a beginner. If you're a bit more advanced, you might want to try some finger picking, something like that. Something a little bit straightforward, but it gives it a little bit more interesting sound. Okay, so that's your basic chord sequence over nearly all of the song. That will work, so get practicing, get singing that one. And you will notice towards the end of the song, there's a really nice part of it where it kind of changes to a bit of a piano breakdown. And all you do there, it starts off, you'll probably recognise it when it comes in, you've got the regular chords first with the piano, A minor, to C, minor E, but then chucks in the F,
oh pretty baby,
to G,
shouldn't have let you,
back to F,
gone, whoa, I must confess that my loneliness,
and then you're back on the regular chords, the A minor, the E major. So let's just have a quick look again. All that does, like I was saying, is the F major,
oh pretty baby, da 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 da,
does that again, F,
is killing.
to F.
Give me a sign.
F and then G, E.
The loneliness is killing me.
And then back to the beginning again, okay? So let's just have a little look at that bridge again. You got F.
Oh, pretty baby. Da,
da, da, to G. F again.
Oh.
And G. And then it goes back to a normal chord sequence again, A minor.
He's killing me now.
And C. D minor and E. But then F.
That you will be here.
G.
And give me a
F. And then a real quick change. F. And then G. E major. And then back to the regular chords.
The loneliness is killing me, and I must confess I still believe.
And so on, okay? So just to recap, really straightforward, almost all of the song, A minor for four, E major for four, C for four, and then a quick D minor and E. And then just that last bridge at the end, you've got two lots of F and G.
Oh, pretty baby, I shouldn't have let you go.
Then it does a regular A minor chord sequence again.
It's killing me now.
To F,
give me a sign,
and then it goes
F,
and then G, E, and then back to the A minor bit again. Okay, so pretty straightforward there. Really, really good song. Keep practicing it. Obviously, I've had the chords written down on the screen, so you just go through those chords as much as you can, get it perfect. That will play along with the Britney Spears version perfectly. If your voice is a little bit different, just try doing it with the capo in different positions, if you've got a higher voice or a lower voice, whatever. I quite like doing this one with no capo, so it's a little bit deeper, but just obviously it's going to be your regular A minor, all the same chords without the capo. Give it a try, keep singing, it'll sound great. Thanks and see you next time.